Okay, so let's start with why biologists need big computers. I know, except one mathematician, most of us are biologists here, but then all of us know the big trend. How many of you have not seen this graph? Okay, so if you've not seen this graph, this is essentially when sequencing began in 2001, and you can see the cost drastically drop down. This is the 2019, and now it's only about $1,000 to actually get an entire genome sequence, which is pretty awesome. And ignore the Moore's law, because even that doesn't hold true anymore, but that's essentially to tell you that we're sequencing lots of stuff because it's getting really cheap, and computers are also increasing their speeds, and because of that, we're generating lots of data, and they have to be analyzed, and that's why biologists are starting to use computers and why we need high-performance computing. And I'm sure all of you have your reasons as to why you're here, otherwise you would not be here on learning command line and high-performance computing. So the biggest effect is cheap. Sequencing is getting really cheap. This is eliminating a lot of roadblocks for many of our research. And a couple examples. The fun one is the nanopore or the MinION. Many of you know about the MinION sequencer. It's essentially this small. This is the sequencer. So you can now take it out in the field and actually do sequencing on the spot in your field station. And the prep kit is actually 10 minutes right now, and it's pretty awesome. So this is a live example of someone who's up in Antarctica in basically the research station doing sequencing on the spot. And there's lots of other fun examples you can go check out on Nanopore's website as well. So genome scale, genome projects have been increasing. Here's a couple examples. We started off with just a couple projects, like one or two, but now you can see this drastic increase. We have like so many that goes on to saying we have 1 million this project, 1,000 genome projects. Earth Microbiome Project, where they're trying to sequence all the microbiome from everywhere possible. Like the 1,000 Cancer Genome Project, the 100 Project that's studying cow rumen microbiomes and so on. It just goes on to just show that it's possible. Everybody is moving towards big data. And because of this now, there's more reason when you're publishing to notice that you need more statistical power to show the link. You no longer can just use one data set. You actually have to show multiple now to publish. And to show that, yes, we do have a significance of a statistical power to show that we are linking right. So because of this, these small numbers that previously used to get reported in computational papers or like in, when you're doing your genome analysis, these are nice, like we've used this much memory, we've used this much compute time and everything. This no longer holds true because now it's boring because the computers have gotten faster and now you have supercomputers or high-performance clusters. So it's no longer even being reported because these numbers are not significant anymore. And to give you another new example, I think this was last year in 2018, this was biology data that was used on studying genes and opioid addiction from like, I think, veterans data, data from the Veteran Genome Project or the Veteran Project, and they used exascale. So exascale is basically the high-performance computer that we have or that I'll be talking about from IU. Much, much faster than that, like really fast. And even then, to go through this many, over the 20 years data sets, it took weeks to go through it, even in an exascale computer. So if you're here wondering why you need to learn this, if you're forced here because your PIs asked you to, or like you're like, wait a second, do I really need this much? Yes, you do. That's where the trend is moving, and that's where we're all heading towards. It took 7 days to run through the sequence. So the wider effect is that biological data is increasing. NCBI, if any of you know the Sequence Read Archive, this is like my fun project to work on, it has about 11 petabytes of data. So if you're buying hard drives that are terabytes, this is much bigger than that. And even NCBI is starting to question how to host this data because it's becoming too much. Because this is 11 petabytes as of now, and it's exponentially increasing the number of data sets that we host. The Gordon Bell Prize for Exascale Calculations on Berkeley Lab was once again on model climate data to show that once again this is necessary. And informatics training is the biggest bottleneck now. It's not that we don't have computers, we have computers and we have biologists. Biologists are generating all this amazing data. Computational scientists are working on building these amazing clusters. It's the training, it's that interlink between them that is lacking, and that's why there's that's why we're here. Another example that I just found out is in 2016, they did a survey on all the NSF bio PIs, which is just one directory, one section of NSF grants. they asked all the PIs there who were awarded to say, okay, can you tell us, like, what is your biggest need? And it turns out it was actually training. It's like there's all this amazing work that's being done, and the blue bar is basically how much is already met, and then the gray is how much is unmet, and you can see that there's a big gap in training. And so this is just a brief overview on why biologists do need this and how it's all possible, but training is what's lacking, and that's why we're here.